Hi everyone, welcome to Headphone.ph YouTube channel. Today we have another headphone up for review. This is the Audio-Technica APH MSR7 SE, which is the special edition of the MSR7 headphone. Let's go check it out. The MSR7 SE is a full-size over-ear headphone from Audio-Technica and retails for $388. This one's a limited edition model, which means it's available in limited quantities. I don't know if this is still available, but I see this often floating on used marketplaces or clearance sales. And here in the Philippines, the retail price is close to 20,000 pesos, but there's a clearance sale that made this cost 10,500. So usually special edition models are just a different type of color or an added accessory here and there. But the MSR7 SE is actually using a retuned drivers from the MSR7 and is coated in diamond-like carbon, which is a sturdier material that sort of like reinforces the movements of the diaphragm. So I reviewed the original MSR7 when it was first released, and even though it's a popular portable full-size headphone, its main complaint is that it just didn't have enough bass. So, and that's a big no-no nowadays with consumers, general consumers and audiophiles alike wanting to have bass, a lot of bass in their headphones. So because it doesn't have a lot of bass, you know, the headphone sounded bright to like a lot of people, and that me included. So the retuned drivers of the MSR7 aims to provide more like bass presence while also balancing out the overall tonal response of the headphone. Aside from a tweak driver, a stronger diaphragm coating, and obviously the aesthetics, the other difference with the special edition model is the package and accessorization. So the old MSR7 comes in a plain cardboard box, while the special edition comes in a much nicer box, as well as the presentation. So the presentation is nicer, but also there's plenty more accessories in this one. So as you can see, there is this nice hard-sided cable that didn't exist in the original model. The original model just had the drawstring soft pouch that won't do anything to protect the headphone. This one also comes with three set of cables. So two of them have a remote microphone in it, the other one doesn't. And then there's another special cable in this accessory box here that is said to provide better audio than a normal cable. The build is also slightly tweaked. So aside from the color of this headphone, which I find to be gorgeous, the navy blue and the gold trim here, the MSR7 SE is also lighter, so I don't know what causes the overall lightness here, but I did find that the headband here has a notch. So in previous models, it's I'm not sure if you can see it here, but it has an empty space here and here, so that they can put a thicker padding that can hopefully make this a more comfortable headphone. It also appears to be less creaky than before. It still creaks if you can hear it like this, but it's not as creaky as I remember the MSR7 to be. Both the ear pad padding and headband padding feels more supple as well to my memory. It's not it's a synthetic leather, but I feel like it's got a nice like softness and bounce to it. Like most portables, it is a single-sided entry, and the 3.5mm cable goes into the left ear cup. And as mentioned, there are three cables that come with this, so you have plenty to use if you lose or if the cable malfunctions. Comfort-wise, it's okay. It's got a little clamp, so I imagine the clamp goes away after some time, but it kinda hugs your head a bit. But also the inside part of the headphone is a little shallow, so your ears are gonna be touching this part here. I didn't find it too uncomfortable, but it's just something that I wanna put out there in case you have a different feeling or opinion on that. Isolation is very good with passive noise isolation is very good with this headphone. I'm surprised that it's able to isolate a ton of noise more than some of the closed back headphones that I have here, namely the Meze 99 Classics, the Odyssey Sign, and the Focal Spirit Classic. This headphone bests all of those in terms of passive noise isolation. So I feel like with the lightweight nature of this and the nice isolation, it can work as a commute type of portable headphone. So with the tweaked drivers and a DLC coating in the diaphragm, does it fix the flaws of the MSR7? I think the answer is yes. So the first thing that strikes me when I listened using this headphone is that it has more bass than the MSR7. It's still not, I would say that it still lacks some extension to like sub-bass extension, but it's not as severe as the previous model. So with this one, there's a good amount of mid-bass and sub-bass, some sub-bass extension, but you know, still not as deep as, for example, the Meze 99 Classics. But the upper bass here is slightly emphasized to compensate for that. So I would say the overall frequency response of this is what people call W-shaped. So it's like an emphasized upper bass, an emphasized upper mids, and an emphasized like mid and high trebles. So I initially want to say this is a neutral headphone, but I think saying it's got a W-shaped response is more appropriate. It does give the neutral kind of impression subjectively, because it's kind of fast, energetic, and lively sounding with the emphasis on various frequencies. As mentioned, it's got a better overall like bass body than the old MSR7. It's not as lean sounding anymore as what the MSR7 used to be from memory. I don't have the MSR7 now, but it did always strike me as a little lacking in like up, like in body, bass body. The bass is a good punch, maybe a little loose because of the emphasis in the upper bass. Usually upper bass is something that's like shelved down. But the upper bass emphasis sort of also transitions well to the lower mid-range, where again, this headphone does well. So the upper mid-range of this headphone is emphasized again. And it's sort of like kind of like the Edmonic line, where you know it kind of gives that life to the vocals and instruments in those range. And the disadvantage, of course, is it can be too much. So for female vocals, it can be a little too shouty. For guitar strings, it can be too prominent or too like it has excessive bite. And the treble part here is also very good. It's still a bright headphone. I think it's not as bright as the original MSR7, but it's because the shift in the response is adjusted. So what made the MSR7 brighter than what it is was the lack of body in the bass area. And with this one, because there's more bass quantity here, it sort of like makes the overall tilt less counterclockwise. So you get some more bass, that which in turn balances out the high frequencies more. However, the treble can still be fatiguing. So I did find that it's too shimmery for my liking. So it's got some 9 kilohertz elevation based on the frequency response graphs. It does have a good top air, but it does give that like persistence haze or shimmery to the music. That can be quite unpleasant over a long listening session, because it sort of like gives that fatiguing feel. Just like the original MSR7, I feel this has a good transient response, so cymbal hits are very quick. The overall resolution of treble is also very good. It's not it's not peaky or sibilant. It's just bright. It just has got that like shimmer or extra splashiness to the music that can be fatiguing after some time. Another improvement over the MSR7 is the soundstage. I was pleasantly surprised that this has a good soundstage, like a good depth and width to it. Now, it's still not an open headphone, and you're not going to mistake this as an open headphone, but comparing this to the old MSR7 from memory and some of, again, the same set of sealed headphones that I have here, this one has the better soundstage compared to those headphones. It's also got good detail retrieval because of probably how it's tuned. The timbre is, to me, it's slightly metallic, almost similar to like the Beyer Dynamic headphones. But it's just light, it's not as pronounced as those headphones. It's still pretty pleasing to listen to. I think it's the mid treble and high treble elevation that sort of gives that that feel to this. But overall, I have no problems with the timbre and the dynamics of this headphone. Another thing that's good with this is it's a very efficient headphone. So I did use this straight from my laptop's audio output, and it did sound fine. I think it does scale a bit when used with an amplifier. It does give, to my ears, it gives a better like overall resolution and dynamics when you're using an amplifier. The amplifier that I used is the DTHX887. And the special cable that came with this, you know, I usually don't believe that cables make sound differences, but in my testing time with using the cable, the special cable and the normal cables, I find that the special cable produces like a more open sound, it seems. It's got a slight improvement in the bass punch, and it's hard to describe, but it's just, to me, a more open sound than using the normal cable. So all in all, the MSR7 SE is a very good sounding headphone. Again, it's not a warm headphone. It still classifies as a bright headphone. So I can see that a lot of people would pass up on this, especially with the high price tag. But overall, I kind of like it as a portable headphone. If we're just dealing with the sound, then I think the MSR7 SE is a good buy, provided that you are not sensitive to bright headphones. Otherwise, as a special edition, I just think it's way too expensive for the type of headphone that it is. The MSR7, the original MSR7, is already expensive at $200. There is an MSR7B. The B stands for balance, and that one is less expensive than this one. I have not heard that, but I've read that it's got more bass as well. So I would say that's probably a better buy if you can addition that. If you're around this type of signature and don't mind spending less, I think the M50X, also from Audio Technica, it is edgier sounding, has slightly worse overall treble resolution and mid-range clarity, but that one is kind of similar sounding to this one. It's available for significantly less at, I think, $150. Also, the Drop DHX Panda, which is kind of the opposite of this one in that it's got more bass and less treble, but that one's wireless, whereas this one is not. And finally, the Odyssey Sign as well, which I don't know if it's still available, but that one sounds very similar with this. It's an on-ear headphone though. It's got a better build quality and has lesser accessories than this one at a similar price. That's about it for the review of the Audio Technica MSR7 SE. I'd love to hear your thoughts on what you think of this headphone, or if you've already tried this one. Likewise, feel free to leave comments in the comment section below. Thumbs up the video if you like it, subscribe for more headphone.ph video reviews, and visit headphone.ph for the text version of this review. I'll see you guys next time.